Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're working out percentage increases or decreases, but we're not allowed to use a calculator. So linking to what we've previously learned on Hegarty Maths, we've done things like find 110% of 60 and find 90% of 60. And we've done it using 10% methods and also using decimal multipliers. So I just want to show you both to recap. To find 110% of £60, first state what 100% is. 100% is your original amount, 60. Now 10% we find by dividing by 10. So that's going to be 6. So therefore 110% is going to be these two added together, which will be £66. The other way of doing it is to say 110% is 1.10 as a decimal, and we're going to multiply that by 60. Now we could go away and we could say, well, let's do 11 multiplied by 6 is 66. Therefore 1.1 multiplied by 6 is 6.6, and therefore 1.1 multiplied by 60 brings us back to 66 again. And hence we would have got the answer 66 that way as well. Okay? Alternatively, say we were finding out 90% of something. Firstly, state you've got 100% is £60, and this time we're subtracting 10%. So we're going to take off 10%, i.e. take off £6, and we would have got ourselves £54. The alternative with the decimal multiplier, 90% as a decimal is 0.90, and you multiply that by 60, and that would also get you £54 using related calculations. Okay, so it's up to you which you prefer using 10% or decimal multipliers, although later on we're solely going to be using these when we are allowed our calculator. But when we are not allowed our calculator, maybe this way is slightly easier. As we go through this video, I will show you the using 10% method fully, and I will just show you what the calculation was with a decimal multiplier, but not go into the detail how to work it out. That's because in future, when it's complex calculations, I want you to be able to get the calculator out and do it this way. Okay, let's try some percentage increase or decrease questions. We are asked to increase £80 by 10%. Now it's really important you read the question here. It's not saying find 10% of £80, it's saying increase £80 by 10%. And the way I look at it is as follows. If you originally had £80, that is worth 100%. If you increase by 10%, you're adding on an extra 10%, and you're leaving with yourself at the end 110%. So when I see a question like this, I translate it to actually, instead of increase £80 by 10%, I translate it to find 110% of £80, because that's exactly equivalent question. It increase £80 by 10% leaves me with 110% at the end, so I can just find 110% of £80. So let's do that using tens. The first thing I state is always how much 100% is worth. 100% is worth £80. Now 10%, we find 10% by dividing by 10, and that's worth £8. So therefore, 110% must therefore be worth £80 plus £8, which is £88. Done. Now, using the decimal multiplier, we would just use 1.10 and we would multiply it by 80. And trust me, you get the same answer, £88. Right, let's try another one. Decrease 70 grams by 10%. So this time we are doing a decrease question, so got to read carefully, by 10%. Think about what's happening. At the start, before you did anything, you must have 100%. You are decreasing, so you are subtracting 10%. You are leaving yourself at the end with only 90%. So the equivalent question to decrease 70 grams by 10% is find 90% of 70 grams. Okay? So let's always state what 100% is, just for our benefit. 100% is 70 grams. 10% is going to be 7 grams. Therefore, 90% must be 100% subtract 10%, which is 70 grams, take away 7 grams, which must be 63 grams, and we're done. Using the decimal multiplier, we would find 90% of 70 grams by doing 0.90 multiplied by 70, and trust me, you would get 63 grams as well if you did it that way. Right, next one. Pause the video and have a go. Increase £50 by 30%, so we're doing an increase question, we're increasing by 30%, so we will do 100, add 30, is going to be equal to 130% at the end of it. So the equivalent question is find 130% of £50. Okay, so let's do that. Always state 100% and it's worth. 100% is the original amount, £50. Therefore, let's find 10%. 10% is going to be that divided by 10, which is going to be £5. And 30% is going to be 3 lots of £5. So it's going to be 3 lots of £5, which is going to be equal to £15. Now, it asked us to increase £50 by 30%. We translated this into find 130%. So we're going to have 100% here, and we're going to take 30% and we're going to add them together to say that 130% is therefore 50, add 15, which is going to be £65. Doing it with decimal multipliers, we would have just done 1.30 multiplied by 50. Trust me, you would get yourself £65 as well. Next one, pause the video, have a go. If we're decreasing 40 grams by 30%, at the end of it, we will have ourselves 70%, won't we? So this is like working out 70% of 40 grams. It's the same idea. So let's start off by starting with 100%. 100% is 40 grams, okay? And 10%, therefore, we divide by 10, so that would be 4 grams. So 70%, let's say, is going to be 7 lots of 10%, 7 multiplied by 4, which is going to be 28 grams. Alternatively, using decimals, you could have typed 0.70 multiplied by 40, and you would also get 28 grams. Trust me on that one. And pause the video, have a go. So if we're increasing by 25%, at the end of it, we're going to have 125%. So this is the same as finding 125% of $120. Okay, so start off by saying what 100% is. It's $120. Therefore, let's work out 10%. 10% must be that divided by 10, which is $12. And 5% must be half of 10%, which is equal to $6. So to get ourselves 125%, we're going to need 120 and 5. So let's go first and work out 20%. It's going to be double 10%. So double 12 is going to be 24. So to get ourselves 125, let's take 100, let's take 5, and let's take 20, and let's add them together so that we say that 125% is therefore equal to 120, add 24, which is 144, add 6, which is going to be equal to $150. Okay, and similarly, decimal multipliers, we would have just done 1.25 multiplied by 120, and we'd have got $150 as well. Next one. Decrease 80 grams by 12.5%. Now think of it, if you had 100 and you subtracted 12.5, if you subtract 12, you get yourself to 88. So if you subtract 12.5, you get yourself to 87.5%. So let's state 100%. 100% is equal to 80 grams. 10% must be equal to 8 grams. 5% must be half of that, which will be 4 grams. And 2.5% must be half of that again, which would be 2 grams. Now, we need 87.5, so we're going to need 80% as well. 80% must be 8 lots of 10%, which would be 64 grams. To get ourselves 87.5%, we'll take the 80, we'll take the 5, and we'll take the 2, and we'll add them together to say 87.5% would therefore be 64, add 2, add 4, which would be 70 grams. And if you did it with decimal multipliers, you would do 0.875 multiplied by 80, and trust me, you'd get the same answer. Okay, and last one's a worded problem. Pause and have a go. Colin pays £120 a week rent. His landlord increases the prices as a present to him by 12.5%. What's his new rent? So he was originally paying rent which was worth 100%. If you add 12.5%, you're working out 112.5%. So 100%, that was £120. Therefore, 10% would be 12. Therefore, 5% would be half of that is 6, and therefore 2.5% would be half of that again, which would be 3. If we're trying to work out 112.5, we take 100, we take 10, and we take 2.5, and 112.5% would therefore be equal to 120, add 12, 132, add 3 is 135. So the answer would be £135, and that's it, we're done for this video.